It's time for English on the Go, which means we'll look at a clip sent to us from a native speaker who could be anywhere in the world. And of course, they're going to be talking about our topic of today, which is childproofing.
네, 오늘 주제 childproof 또는 childproofing에 대해서 오스트리아의 블루인스 씨가 이야기를 해줄 겁니다. 어떤 경험이 있는지 한번 이야기 들어볼까요?
블루인스 씨, 나와주세요.
I have a friend who's really good with children, and she had this idea that she wanted to start a daycare where parents could drop off their child at her house, she would take care of them during the day, and the parent could pick up the child back in the evening. So basically babysitting just at her house. But in order to do this, she would have had to make sure her whole house is childproof. What this means is making sure the environment is safe for a child. So it could be setting up barriers on top of the staircase, or it could be covering any sharp edges of furniture with foam, just to make sure the child doesn't fall down and hurt itself. So it would have been too much hard work to make sure her whole house is childproof, and she gave up on the idea in the end. I can only start to imagine how much hard work childproofing is for new parents.
Yeah, I bet it is pretty hard because so many things you don't even think about could be dangerous for the child, right?
보통은 근데 방금 전에 이야기하신 것처럼 가구, 모서리나 이런 것들을 뭐 막는 것보다도 물건 빨리 다 치우는 게 더 바쁘죠.
Right.
날카로운 거, 드라이버 이런 것들 치우는 거, 챙겨놓는 거.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
All right, so let's talk a little bit more about this as we go into details.
Okay, that's great. Let's start with the first line then.
I have a friend who's really good with children.
I have a friend who is really good with children.
첫 번째 문장인데요. I have a friend, 친구가 한 명 있는데 어떤 친구라고요?
A friend who is really good with children.
네.
To be good with.
네. To be good with라고 하면은 어떤 것을 잘하거나 잘 다루는 걸 말합니다. 그래서 아이들을 아주 잘 다루는 친구가 한 명 있대요. 그런 친구들이 누구나 있거든요.
Of course, everybody has a friend who is good with children, right?
Yeah, because I was never somebody good with children.
But now you are?
I think I'm better than before.
Right.
전보단 나아진 것 같아요. 자, 그러면 이 good with 뭐뭐뭐라고 하는 표현 어떻게 이해하면 좋은지 설명드리겠습니다. 네, be good at 아시죠? Be good at 하면은 뭔가 어떤 거를 잘하는 건데요. Be good with라는 말도 있어요. 그래서 가끔씩 문맥에 따라서 잘한다라는 말도 있는데 결과적으로는 잘 다루다는 뜻이에요. 왜냐하면 with 자체가 가지고 있거나 함께 있을 때를 이야기하잖아요. 그래서 잘 다루다라는 뜻으로 예를 들어 첫 번째 she's good with computers라고 하면요. 컴퓨터와 함께 좋습니다. 이렇게 직역하면 말이 안 되겠죠. She's good with computers. 컴퓨터를 잘 다루어요. 그러니까 she's good at using computers. 이런 말로 바꾸실 수도 있을 거예요. 그리고 이런 예문도 가능합니다. They are good with children. 본문에 나왔던 거랑 똑같죠. 그들은 아이들을 잘 다룹니다. 또는 I'm good with dogs. 이렇게 말하면 무슨 말일까요? 개가 있으면, 개들이 있으면 잘 지낸다? 그런 게 아니고 저는 개를 잘 다루어요. 그래서 여러분이 저는 뭐뭐를 잘 다룹니다. 그게 어떤 도구가 되었건, 어떤 사람이 되었건, 아니면 동물이 되었건, 어떤 환경이 되었건 거기에 with 뒤에 써주시면 다 잘 다룬다라는 뜻이 됩니다. 참고로 꼭 알아두시고요. 다음 문장 보시죠.
And she had this idea that she wanted to start a daycare where parents could drop off their child at her house.
And she had this idea that she wanted to start a daycare where parents could drop off their child at her house.
먼저 나오는 단어가 보육센터나 어린이집을 가리키는 것이
daycare. Daycare.
Daycare. Mm-hmm. 낮 동안 봐주는 거예요.
Yeah, somebody's taking care of your child during the day.
네, during the day. So yeah. Daycare 말 그대로 어린이집이라고 할 수 있고요. Mm-hmm. 그리고 맡겨두다.
Drop off. Drop off.
보통 drop 하면 떨어뜨리는 거고요. 네, 떨어뜨렸다가 잡았어요. Nice catch. Drop off 하면은 이거는 원래 차를 태우고 가서 Where shall I drop you off 하면 어디에 내려줄까요?
You can drop me off at that corner.
저쪽 모서리에 또 저쪽에 세워주세요 라고 하는 건데요. Drop off. 아이를 지금 차를 태워서 가서 내려주는 걸 상상을 해보시면 비슷해요. 맡기는 거.
Yeah, and it's the same thing for packages or anything. Can you drop it off in front of my door?
아,
or something like that.
현관 앞에 놔주세요.
Yeah.
네. 그래서 same. drop off 하면 놓다, 내려주다, 맡기고 가다라는 뜻인데요. 그래서 전체 문장은 And she had this idea, 어떤 생각이 났어요. That she wanted to start a daycare 어린이집을 시작하고 싶다라는 생각이 났고요. Mm-hmm. Where parents, 이 where라는 것은 바로 어린이집이 어떤 공간인가 하면 mm-hmm. 부모들이 could drop off their child at their house. Mm-hmm. 그녀의 집에 아기를 맡기고 가는 거예요.
Mm-hmm. 네. At her house. Oh, so it's like an in-house daycare, basically. 네.
집에서 하는 어린이집을 만들고 싶었다는 이야기입니다.
Okay, let's see what else she tells us about that next.
She would take care of them during the day, and the parent could pick up the child back in the evening.
She would take care of them during the day, and the parent could pick up the child back in the evening.
아까 drop이 나오고 바로 pick up 하니까 마치 진짜로 물건을 떨어뜨렸다가 줍는 것처럼 느껴지지만
yeah.
그래도 말은 되는데 yeah. 여기서 말하는 것은 떨어진 것을 줍는다기보다는 데리고 가다.
Yeah, so pick up a child, the same thing, you can pick up a package. Mm-hmm. You drive by, okay, thank you, take it and go.
맞아요, yeah. 찾아가는 거예요. Mm-hmm. She would라고 하는 거는 이제 만약 이것을 시작한다면 그렇게 mm-hmm. 할 상황이었던 거죠. Mm-hmm. 그렇게 했을 테죠. She would take care of them, 아이들을 돌봐주고 during the day, 낮에, and the parent, 그 부모가 could pick up the child back in the evening. Mm-hmm. 일단 back이라는 거를 안 넣어도 똑같은 의미가 되는데
yeah.
back이 들어간 이유는 she or the parent put the child there uh-huh. and they're taking the child back.
Yeah, but she said the sentence a little bit in a way that's difficult to understand. Mm. Usually someone might say the parent could pick back up the child later. Something like that.
Back가 좀 더 앞으로 왔을 수도 있는데 uh-huh. back in the evening 그러니까 저녁에 돌아간다 이런 게 아니고
yeah.
pick up the child하고 back를 같이 생각해서
yep.
이해하시면 좋을 것 같습니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 부모가 저녁에 아이들을 다시 데리고 가는 거예요. 그 mm-hmm. 다시가 back 이 부분에 다시 찾아간다라는 mm-hmm. 의미로 들어가 있어요.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see what she says next.
So basically babysitting just at her house.
So basically babysitting just at her house.
이런 형태의 문장도 자주 볼 수 있는데요. Mm-hmm. So basically A, just at 뭐뭐뭐. Mm-hmm. 그래서 기본적으로 babysitting인데 just at her house. 단지 그녀의 집에서 하는 거예요.
Mm-hmm.
So basically it's studying just more fun.
Yeah, so basically it's working just in the park.
맞아요. 그냥 기본적으로 일하는 건데 just at the park or in the park.
Yeah.
공원에서 일할 뿐 일하는 건 똑같아. Mm-hmm. Basically 뭐가 있을까요? Taking a test just knowing all the answers.
It could be different. So you can be like, so basically just a burrito but with kimchi. I don't know.
아, 좀 이렇게 순서를 바꿀 수도 yeah. 있겠네요. 오케이, okay, uh-huh. 좋아요. 그래서 basically A, just B 이 uh-huh. 형태도 종종 나오니까 기억해 주시고 uh-huh. 바로 다음 문장 보겠습니다.
Uh-huh. But in order to do this, she would have had to make sure her whole house is childproof.
But in order to do this, she would have had to make sure her whole house is childproof.
하지만 이것을 하기 위해서 in order to do this. 발음할 때 in order to do this 천천히 발음하는 경우 잘 못 보고요.
Yeah, we don't usually say it slowly. It's usually very fast. In order to do this.
맞아요. In order to do this. In order to do this. In order to do this. 여러분도 얼마나 빨리까지 할 수 있는지 한번 해보세요. In order to do this. In order to do this. She would have had to make sure. 만약 하려고 했다면 mm-hmm. 지금 안 했어요. 안 했기 때문에 she right. had to 했어야 mm-hmm. 합니다가 아니고 또는 했어야 했어야도 아니고요. She would have had to.
Mm-hmm.
만약에 했더라면 그렇게 했어야 했을 거예요.
Mm-hmm.
어디까지나 가정이에요.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure 확실하게 뭔가를 하는 거예요. Mm-hmm. Her whole house was 또는 is childproof.
Mm-hmm.
집 전체가 childproof. 아이들이 안전한 상태가 되어야 하는 거죠.
For sure. And she tells us more about what childproof means next.
What this means is making sure the environment is safe for a child.
What this means is making sure the environment is safe for a child.
What this means, 이 부분이 하나의 주어예요.
Mm-hmm.
이것이 의미하는 바,
mm-hmm.
what this means,
what 딱, this means.
네, 그 뜻이 그 is, 해서 is가 꼭 필요합니다.
Mm-hmm.
어떤 분들은 이제 means가 동사인데 oh, 왜 또 is가 또 붙느냐? 왜냐하면 what this means가 하나의 명사라고 생각하시면 돼요.
Right, it's, a noun it's one group. Thing, it's like yeah. one noun. So you yeah. have to say is. What?
네, 그냥 is가 빠지게 되면 동사가 없는 거예요, 이 전체 문장에.
Mm-hmm.
So what this means mm-hmm. is, 또는 the meaning of this is mm-hmm. making sure the environment is safe for a child. 이 집이라는 환경을 아이에게 안전하게 만들어주는 거예요.
Mm-hmm. And she gives us examples of this next.
So it could be setting up barriers on top of the staircase, or it could be covering any sharp edges of furniture with foam.
So it could be setting up barriers on top of the staircase, or it could be covering any sharp edges of furniture with foam.
처음부터 차근차근 보겠습니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 it could be 뭐뭐일 수도 있어요. 지금 나열하고 있습니다. Mm-hmm. Setting up, 설치하는 건데 무엇을?
Barriers. Barrier.
Barrier. Mm-hmm. 장벽, 장애물, 울타리 같은 건데요. Mm-hmm. 울타리예요. 여기서는 on top of the staircase라고 했네요. Mm-hmm.
Staircase. Staircase.
Stair. 물론 우리는 stairs, mm-hmm. upstairs, downstairs. 이 세 가지가 가장 익숙한데
right.
stair라는 stairs라는 말들은 사실 그 하나 하나 계단 한 칸 한 칸이 다 stair, stair, stair잖아요.
Stair. So that's why we say stairs.
Stairs.
Because there are many.
네.
But there's one staircase
그렇죠.
with many stairs.
네.
Yeah.
책장이 bookcase고 mm-hmm. 거기에 books가 꽂혀 있잖아요. Mm-hmm. 그 느낌으로 생각하시면 staircase 그 계단 전체. Mm-hmm. 한 층에서 다른 층으로 가는 이렇게 하나짜리를 staircase라고 해요. 그래서 mm-hmm. staircase 계단 맨 위에 울타리를 설치하거나 mm-hmm. or it could be covering any sharp
edges. Edge. Edge. This 네. is the edge of the cars.
네. 가장자리. Mm-hmm. 그래서 가장자리나 모서리인데요. 그래서 edges of furniture 가구의 날카로운 sharp edges, 모서리들을 덮는 걸 수도 있어요. With?
Foam. Foam.
Foam. Mm-hmm. 우리가 스티로폼이라고 할 때 그 폼이 바로 styrofoam에서 온 건데요. Mm-hmm. Foam 하면은 발포 고무를 가리킬 수도 있겠고 mm-hmm. You can also create some foam with your soap.
Yeah, with your soap. So you can have foamy soap, right? Just any light, airy material like that,
네.
right?
거품을 soap이라고 할 수도 있고 스타일러폼도 비슷한 느낌으로 좀 가볍잖아요.
Right.
그래서 이제 발포 고무를 말하는데 그래서 고무로 덮는 것도 가구의 날카로운 모서리를 덮는 것도 그것에 해당이 될 겁니다.
Mm-hmm. And she finishes the sentence next.
Just to make sure the child doesn't fall down and hurt itself.
Just to make sure the child doesn't fall down and hurt itself.
Just to make sure라는 것은 반드시 뭐뭐 하도록 하기 위해서 mm-hmm. the child doesn't fall down and hurt itself. Mm-hmm. 넘어져서 다치지 않도록. 넘어지는 거야 막을 수가 없다고 하더라도
right.
doesn't fall down, 아예 넘어지는 거 막을 수는 없어요.
Yeah.
and 합쳐서 생각하시면 좋아요.
Right, because they will probably fall down on the mats that you have on the floor, mm-hmm. foam mats mm-hmm. on the floor,
네.
maybe, but they 네. won't get hurt.
네, 그리고 itself라고 한 이유는 그 아이가 남자아이인지 여자아이인지 모르기 때문에
right.
baby 같은 경우는 여전히 it라고 할 때가 많아요.
Yeah, especially because we don't know like if it's going to be a boy or a girl in that case, and also for children, just, you know, itself.
네, 아직은 성인으로 생각하지 않기 때문에 yeah. 그런지 아주 갓난아기 같은 경우는 it. 이라고도 많이 합니다. 오케이,
mm-hmm.
okay. 다음 문장 볼까요?
Mm-hmm. So it would have been too much hard work to make sure her whole house is childproof, and she gave up on the idea in the end.
Okay, let's see what she says. So it would have been too much hard work to make sure her whole house was childproof, and she gave up on the idea in the end.
이 문장 앞부분이 좀 재밌게 들렸죠?
Yeah, it sounded like she said, So, 여러분, too much hard work. 그렇게, I'm not even Korean and I heard that one.
그렇게 들렸어요.
yeah.
근데 이제 실제로 여러분이라고 말한 건 아니고
yeah.
It would have been.
Uh-huh. Would it have been. would have been too.
네, 여러분, 비슷하게 들린 It would have been.
Yeah.
It would have been too much hard work. 만약 그렇게 했다면 너무 힘들었을 거예요. 너무 일이 mm-hmm. 많았을 거예요. To make sure her whole house was childproof.
Yeah.
집 전체를 childproof로 만드는 것은 너무 힘들었어요. 쓸 테니까
mm-hmm.
and she gave up on the idea in the end.
Yeah, in the end she gave up on the idea.
Mm-hmm.
To give up on an idea means you just you quit. You don't strive for it, right?
Give up 하면은 포기하는 건데요.
Yeah.
Give up on something 하면 그것을 포기한다라고 해서 목적어를 쓸 수가 있어요. 그래서
mm-hmm.
그 아이디어를 포기하는 거고요. 결과적으로는 안 했대요.
Mm-hmm. She didn't. So, let's see how she ends her clip in the last sentence.
I can only start to imagine how much hard work childproofing is for new parents.
I can only start to imagine how much hard work childproofing is for new parents.
New parents라는 건 이제 새로운 부모들, 즉 이제 막 아기가 태어난 부모들에게 이 과정이 얼마나 힘든지 저는
I can only start to imagine. Can only imagine.
네, I can only imagine이라는 말 많이 씁니다. 상상만 할 수 있을 뿐.
Yeah, because it's something that you've never really experienced. So I don't have a child, but you do. So I can only imagine how difficult it could be.
Yeah, or how right. delightful it could be. Yeah. 이렇게 말할 수도 있겠는데 only를 빼면 I can imagine 하면 상상돼요.
Yeah.
근데 I can only가 들어가면서 상상만 된다라는 거는 사실 상상도 안 된다.
Uh-huh.
사실 똑같은 말이에요. I can't even imagine.
Yeah.
그래서 I can only 여기서는 start to 시작하는 거예요. 짐작하기 시작만 할 수 있을 뿐 즉 짐작이 안 된다라는 말도 됩니다.
Okay, so why don't we take a look at her clip one more time? Listen carefully for 여러분. Let's watch.
I have a friend who's really good with children, and she had this idea that she wanted to start a daycare where parents could drop off their child at her house, she would take care of them during the day, and the parent could pick up the child back in the evening. So basically babysitting just at her house. But in order to do this, she would have had to make sure her whole house is childproof. What this means is making sure the environment is safe for a child. So it could be setting up barriers on top of the staircase, or it could be covering any sharp edges of furniture with foam, just to make sure the child doesn't fall down and hurt itself. So it would have been too much hard work to make sure her whole house is childproof, and she gave up on the idea in the end. I can only start to imagine how much hard work childproofing is for new parents.